So I want to welcome everybody to the 2020 reorganization meeting of the Town of Orangetown, a town rich in history, which is made even more history tonight by swearing the first town, woman town supervisor in the 221-year history of Rockland County. When I started to prepare my remarks for tonight, I plan to mention this at the very end, but I moved it to the beginning because I know that there are so many people that this was important to them and it was made a big deal in the media. But as much as it is an honor, and it is a huge honor, it is not how I want my tenure supervisor to be defined. I'm an attorney that worked for the town part-time for 23 years. I'm with four town supervisors. I'm an experienced real estate attorney. I'm an active member of the community. I'm a mother, a wife, a sister, a daughter, a neighbor, and a friend. That is who Orangetown elected to be the next town supervisor. With that said, I want to thank the people of the Town of Orangetown for trusting me to be their next town supervisor. It is an honor and a privilege, and I am excited by both the opportunities and the challenges ahead. As promised during the campaign, my administration will work tirelessly every day to move Orangetown in the right direction. I want to start by thanking former Town Supervisor Chris Day for his leadership and strong support for my candidacy. Chris accomplished a lot during his term and started some really exciting projects, including the new Town Hall and Community Center, which are both in final design stages. I look forward to picking up where he left off on these and other initiatives and seeing them through to completion. On a personal note, I want to say that I enjoyed working with Chris Day the last 2 years. I wish him and his family the best and hope that one day he returns to public office. I look forward to working with the members of the town board, Councilmen Troy, Dignity, Valentine, and Vittori, as well as our town clerk, Rosanna Straga, our highway superintendent, Jim Dean, town justice, Pat Lois, and Gretchen Eddy, and all the town department heads, as well as the CSEA and community leadership. I will say there's one thing bittersweet about when you rush, is that I will miss working in the town attorney's office, an office which I've had the pleasure of working in for over 23 years with some of the most professional people I've ever known, both support staff and attorneys. I want to thank Robert Greeno, Dennis Michael, Denise Sullivan, Mir Focola, Barbara Gianza, Mary Ferrara, and Barbara Jurczynski for their friendship and unwavering support during the campaign. I also want to take this opportunity to congratulate Barbara Gianza on the move to the Rockland County District Attorney's Office. It is a loss for the town to gain the people of Rockland, and to Barbara Jurczynski on her recent semi-retirement. We are fortunate to have a great team, a team that is dedicated to serving our community, and I look forward to working with them over the next 2 years. I also want to quickly thank my campaign team. Without their hard work and support, I would not have been successful this past November. I will always be grateful for their confidence in me, and just think we get to do it all over again in another year or so. And finally, I want to thank my family for their support and encouragement over the last 9 months. It was truly special that my 93-year-old father, a retired police officer and World War II veteran, and my 82-year-old mother, the strongest woman I know, were able to vote for me in November. Along with my sisters, Joanna Hodges and Marie Walmsley, and my sister-in-law, Josephine Patton, who were out there every day campaigning for me. My family gave me the strength I needed to go out, knock on doors, and stand in ShopRite, and attend a lot of events around town. But I especially want to thank my husband, Larry, and our two children, Caitlin and Brendan. I could never have stepped forward and run for public office without your love and support. Thank you. First, I believe the town had made significant progress over the last few years, and I did not want to see the town go backwards. And second, I believe that my professional experience gave me something to offer. So as we embark on a new chapter in Orangetown, I will use this experience to focus our attention on the issues that matter most. Together with the town board, we will continue to protect taxpayers by budgeting responsibly. In the coming weeks, I will be working with our department heads to evaluate the needs of each department, ensure that we continue to find savings and efficiencies while ensuring that we have personal resources necessary to best serve county residents. In addition, we'll work with our state representatives to fight for mandate relief, additional AIM funding, and a change to the school aid formula, which has continually shortchanged our school districts, causing property taxes to rise. We will focus on innovative ways to grow our economy by revitalizing our downtown, and we'll work with the state to redevelop our PC. In addition, we will proactively recruit businesses to come to Orangetown, to the Pfizer property, Woodville Plaza, and the Route 303 corridor. Economic development will be a major priority of my administration as we seek to bring in new, clean tax rates and continue on the progress of the town board in bringing in companies like Chase and Google. In addition, we will stop irresponsible development. As I stated during the campaign, this is the most pressing issue throughout Rockland County, and I will use my experience as a local real estate attorney to work with the town board to craft and implement laws designed to address these concerns. The town board has made significant progress by passing laws and taking action, such as increasing fines for town code violators and hiring additional code enforcement officer. However, there is more to be done. Together, we will update the town's already updated comprehensive plan, which has been updated since 2003, and review and strengthen our zoning laws and town code. We'll establish a land trust to purchase undeveloped property like the H&A property in Palisades and Nyack College. We'll continue to judiciously use the PAC, the Planned Adult Community Zone, to allow seniors to stay in the town and to look for other housing options in and around our downtown districts for our young residents to move until they are ready to buy a home in the town. All of these initiatives, community engagement is critical, and we will work transparently and with input from residents to ensure that we do what is in the best interest of the town. Finally, we will safeguard our environment by protecting our water and air quality, preserving open space, investing in our sewer infrastructure, and promoting recycling. As supervisor, I will work with elected officials throughout our town and county, including the river villages, community leaders, and residents to continue the good work of the town board and tackle these issues head on in a bipartisan way, as I have done the last 23 years in the town attorney's office. I'm excited to get to work, and once again, I'm grateful to the people of Orangetown for the opportunity. Thank you.